There's the story of Lord Ram. When he went in Dandakaranya to Pampasar Lake, he was extremely thirsty. So he placed his bow on the earth and stooped to take a drink of water from the lake. Apparently unknown to him, he had put his bow on a frog. So after he had his fill of water, he cast his glance and he found that the frog was badly bruised and cut by the weight of his sarang. So Lord Ram was moved to pity. He said, "My dear frog, what is this? You have been bruised so badly, you did not complain. I have given you such a big throat. You could have made some sound, gwa, gwa, tar, 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 pit, 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 something. You did not cry out." The frog said, "My lord, whenever I have been in trouble, I have cried out to God, to Lord Ram. Today Ram himself is putting me in trouble. Now whom should I cry out to? I am not complaining. I am accepting this as your will. I was praying, give me the strength to bear with this." See, in the Bhagavatam, there is a very powerful verse. Tattenukampam susamikshamano bhunjana evatmakritam vipakam ridvagvapurbhir vidadhan namaste jivetayo bhakti padesadaya bhak. The Bhagavatam says that if you can fulfill these three conditions, then bhakti will become your daya bhak. Daya bhak, uttaradhikar. It's God's property, it will become yours. Three conditions you need to fulfill. What are these? First is tattenukampam susamikshamano. Keep waiting for His grace. Don't complain, God is not blessing me. No, the difficulty is from my side. Tere karam mein kami nahi, tu kareem hai. Kusur mera hai, jhootha ummeedwar hoon main. So, never complain, Lord, why did you not grace? The defect is from my side. I must keep waiting. Second condition, bhunjana evatmakritam vipakam. Whatever sukh, dukh we get as a result of our past karmas, to accept them gracefully without complaining. One disciple went to his guru, "Guruji, I have this problem, this problem, this problem. How will I do sadhana?" Guruji said, "My child, the best sadhana is to tolerate this problem, that problem, that problem, without any negativity. There is no better sadhana." So the second condition is that you tolerate the karmas, karmic reactions which are coming your way without complaint. And the third, ridvag vapurbhir vidadhan namaste. With your body, with your mind, with your word, offer your pranam to the Lord. This is the anukul sankalp, positive thinking towards Him. So the Bhagavad says, if you can just fulfill these three conditions, bhakti will become your daya bhak, your inheritance.